हेलो 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 हेलो, आई एम वेटिंग फॉर माय गेस्ट टू जॉइन मी। हेलो, वेयर इज द ऑडियो कमिंग फ्रॉम? ऑडियो एको कमिंग फ्रॉम समवेयर फ्रेंड्स। होजे,
Say things, say things, say
yeah,
things,
all good,
say
all
things.
good, all good, everything good. I'm just
Say
waiting
things, say
for.
things, say things.
Hey,
Hey,
yeah,
I'm getting an echo.
even
Getting an
I'm
echo
getting an
from
echo.
this. Why? Do you have the stream? Do you have the stream audio on?
No, stream audio is not
Do you
on.
have
Let
the
me just
stream?
check.
Do you have the stream audio on? Hold on. Let me try muting myself and see if it disappears.
Yeah, let me also check.
Hold on. Let me try muting myself and see if it
What a
disappears.
great start, guys. What a great start indeed. What is happening?
Why is your audio looping? You have to have it on somewhere through the. What
Well,
is
at least I know it's not me.
Oh, there we go. That makes sense. It's done. Wait, what? Why is this happening? One second. It's looking normal
What
for
the?
me here. Yeah. Like my Zoom window is normal. Can I?
Like you
Oh.
handled the audio.
Well,
We are
there, I did that.
phenom.
I've zoomed out a bit, but this is 100% how professional. Have you like locked my this thing on OBS or something like that? Like, no
Just
problem.
press the buttons.
I swear to God, this is like
Press
a
them
sequel to
all.
what we do in the shadows. Just three, like two ghosts and a human bubbling around going, I can fix it! I can fix it!
All right,
Guillermo,
now can you guys hear me?
Guillermo.
I've been told I was on mute. I have sorted that out. I've been told that I'll fix Rohan's screen also. I'll just sort that out, guys. Just give me 10 seconds. Bear with me. Thora. Perfect. All good? Looks good?
Looks fine to me.
Yeah, looks good.
Yeah.
Looks good.
I'm also looking. It looks fine.
Looks good. Perfect. Now we can
Now we can
start.
start.
Now we can start. On that note, hello everybody. Hello and welcome. Finally to to this
Yes.
really professional stream that we are doing today.
This is the Blair Witch Project, dude. This is self-made indie
Yeah, of
horror.
course.
This
I would just
is
like
that
to
indie horror shit.
Tell you guys that this mask, while I'm wearing it really doesn't it look like Varun
I was going to say that I look like Varun Thakur, but okay. It's me, Vicky this side. You want to do that side? Vicky this side. Hey, that
Vicky
side.
this side.
Aren't you dying under that mask, Rama? Are
I
you
was going to
panicking?
ask you that. Like, Rama,
I am, I am. I'm
how
gonna.
stanky are you on a scale of 1 to 10 in that mask right
No,
now?
very. So I'm removing it. Oh! Plot twist! It's a plot
Oh
twist!
shit! Oh shit!
It's
He's
a
under two masks!
classic horror movie plot twist. You thought that is how I looked below? I'm not.
That is
Okay, what?
really creepy.
Yeah, this
That,
one
yeah, the
is.
second
That's a
one's
very creepy
actually
one.
hectic,
This
yeah.
is actually the creepiest mask I own. Like, it's got a. It's a. If I'm not wrong, this character is called Slenderina. It's a creepypasta story. So, like, this is like.
Yeah.
Hello. Okay,
God.
now I'm removing because. Oh, okay.
Oh no! This is the worst one. It's the worst.
Put it back
Oh
on.
no!
Put it back on.
Save us! I'm a vampire, but this is too much for me.
God. Oh.
How
Why did
can
I walked right into
Jose's
that
like,
one,
how can
dude?
I be uninvited in? How do you can you kick a vampire out?
I walked.
Leave me now.
I walked right into that one. But welcome everybody who is watching. Welcome to the league.
Hello, League.
Hello, league. Hello, everybody. So Jose, all our entire chat, everyone in the chat is called the league, and we've got our regulars. But
Oh.
today we are also joined by the Pishvi gang members as well as the Har Army. So there are a lot of people here. So
Whoop
hello.
whoop.
This is a classic example of how weird it is when you name the like people from your chat.
Yeah, but
It's very funny.
the league actually is made up of Pishvi gang, Vatana army, and Har army. So it's a very weird
It's
mishmash of.
like going vegetable shopping, basically. You get a bag, you get some peas, you get everything. It's great. Yeah, it's a good story. It's a good story.
We are here to discuss horror movies. So before we start, just a few quick announcements. Yes. Announcement number one, to everybody who is watching, you guys know the drill. Number one, press the like button, smash the like button, and we'll keep asking you to press the like button. Number two, take this link right now and spam all your friend groups. Spam all your friend groups.
All of them.
Sahil, Rohan, and Jose all are live discussing horror movies. Send it to your friends, your family, everybody. Just spam your groups with this link and tell them, come watch this right now. You don't want to miss this. It's the ultimate discussion of the ultimate horror movies. Come on, who doesn't want to miss that?
It's true.
Of course. And what is the third announcement? The third announcement is, please feel free to chat, talk. We'll be replying to your chats. We'll be replying to your super chats. We'll be discussing everything that you guys want us to discuss. So in case we don't address you, be patient. We will come to you. And last but not the least, in the chat, please give a welcome to Jose. Welcome to your first Binge O'Clock episode.
Welcome, Jose. Jose, we thought we wanted you to do something different. So why not get you to talk about ghosts? Let's get Jose to do something different here.
This is different because I just listen most of the time. So I'm not into horror and ghosts, to be honest. I don't like suffering.
Okay.
I don't like putting myself through that. But for you guys,
you're a parent, though. You're a parent.
Yeah, there's enough suffering in my life.
With what straight face are you saying you don't enjoy suffering?
I'm already dealing with that, so. But yeah. Now it's like I get invited to anywhere. There's a new haunted house in the area. They're like, Jose, can you cut the ribbon and all? So I'm like, yeah, of course I'll be there.
Have you 100%. Been to one of these Indian haunted houses, by the way? Have you ever been to any Indian haunted house?
I have. I've been to one in, so when I was a kid, there used to be, I don't know if they still happen, but on Marine Drive, Chowpatty, all those Maidans that are there, some of them used to get taken over and used to have these fairs occasionally.
Yeah.
Like these Anand Mela type things. And sometimes they would have this haunted house. Okay.
Okay.
And not very haunty.
It is not at all. It's
not very haunty. Like the hardest thing in that haunted house is ek to ye maidan pe ho raha hai, matlab ground uneven hai. So half the time you're just spending trying to walk straight without falling over. And at one point this guy came out and sort of grabbed me. And I think he was supposed to be scared. Except walking on that uneven ground and at that point at which he came, it was the most reassuring thing that ever happened to me, because he came and he caught me and I felt more stable. So,
and you're like, thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
I was like this reassuring haunted house.
Yeah. What are these exhibition sort of haunted tours? Is that it?
No. It's literally basically what it's called haunted house, but they basically build one corridor that goes
and then
at random point in the corridor, lights and all will come. And then you'll be like, oh, re, tu bhi party hunters jata hai.
Party hunters.
Dude, I'd been to a similar haunted house in Pune. I'd gone the market city. And the thing is, I remember I'd gone with Aditi Mittal. We were doing a show over there. So then we went to that haunted house.
It's in market city.
Yeah, I don't think if it's there anymore. But till date, it has been the funniest experience ever. Because the ghosts were talking Marathi. So the ghost is like...
Also, how do you sell somebody the idea of a haunted house in the world's most crowded mall? Where it's like, hello, welcome to this horrifying, desolate place. Next door is a bow concept. How does that work?
I think this was for kids and you guys were not supposed to
I think so too. It's the same thing, right? So the thing is, right, earlier...
You could say that about most pop culture, Jose. That has never stopped silent.
What is Comic-Con? Wow.
Get out of my face, 80-year-old.
But they do have serious tours where they take you through crazy things. I think I remember, was it Hyderabad? They take you through the, what's it called? Yeah, Bhool Bhulaiya. That's what they called it. And it's this really deep maze and there's no lights anywhere and stuff. It's actual a tour, a haunted tour where you can actually go. It's not skeleton bahar aayega and all. Proper haunted tours. so to speak.
I've always wanted to go. Like, India has a long haunted history. I mean, sorry guys, we will get to the movies part, otherwise we'll just be talking about the history. But India has a lot of haunted places. There's a place called Bhangar, which is the most haunted place in Rajasthan. It's the most haunted place in India. So like, that's the place where apparently there was a tantric who died, and then he put a curse on while he was dying, and it's full Jol Jamela. So that is the place that I would like to visit one day eventually.
In my experience,
happening on this stream right now.
No, I'm setting your frame up better. Your face was zoomed in, so I'm just quickly setting up while we're having a conversation.
Gorgeous things are happening.
I know, okay. This is very
Ghost in the machine.
No, guys.
Ghost just, in the machine.
This
no,
is
no,
like,
no,
it's very weird. Like, I'm saying haunted house, and there's Rohan just like, woo.
Yeah, just whooshing across the screen.
It's the Matrix.
So, I feel like, everywhere you go in Rajasthan, there's one tour guide who will try to take you to the most haunted place in India.
Yeah.
Okay. I have been taken to two of the most haunted place in India. All right. And all I remember of those places is that they were the most hot and boring places in India.
Yeah, but ghosts don't come.
If you're terrified of unfinished houses, then it's a very scary place. Like, if just the idea of crumbling houses is for some reason inherently terrifying to you, horrific.
Like, that's funny.
It's otherwise,
like, the ghost is coming. He's like, and then he falls down because the stairs crumble, and he's like, oh yeah, I guess this is not good enough for me.
That's it. Yeah, it's like, fine, fair enough. And how haunted can it be? How haunted can it be if 20 meters away there's a fort where a kid comes and says, "Dekhne ka hai to 10 rupees ka ticket." Now, come on.
Then when you go there, the guy's like, "Bacha, koi bacha nahi tha idhar."
Whatever. And then I'll be pissed off. And then who took my 10 bucks?
The craziest stories we get from on the ghost story scene is Rajasthan, Bangalore, Bengal, at least. I mean, so far.
Rajasthan, some in Bangalore, Mumbai. And Bengal. That's an interesting.
It's always stories. Mumbai is the same vibe. But you know, like, I mean, it's always the same, like, bunch of characters. Like, I feel in Indian horror, we've got the same bunch of characters, right? Like, I'll tell you, okay?
Pune. Chat is saying Pune, but Pune
Goa
also
people are saying.
Goa, definitely.
Pune, yeah. Goa.
Guys, I'll tell you, do you all see Indian horror movies? Like, let's talk about the topic. Because if we are talking about horror movies, I have to mention a few Hindi horror movies that I maybe saw as a kid. And right now I saw as an adult, and I think maybe they were not as scary as I thought. Have you all seen this movie called 13B?
I have not seen 13B. What is 13B?
Dude! Okay. 13B has got Madhavan in it. It's on Prime. Please watch it. It's a it's a great horror movie. And I'll explain the very simple plot. This guy moves into a new house with his family. Yeah, and they have this mandir room in which they are putting killas, but the Bhagwan ka photos keep falling. And his mother's watching a TV show. And the TV show is about a family that moves into a new house.
Oh,
it's actually pretty good.
It's actually quite nice.
That sounds great.
I was working at MTV at the time, and we reviewed the film.
Nice.
But it was a good film, a very good film.
I really enjoyed Bhoot, like Ram Gopal Varma's Bhoot
was creepy as well.
I enjoyed the shit out of Bhoot. It was great. I really, really enjoyed it. 100 Days doesn't count as a horror film, right? Even though there was just like there was a skeleton in the wall, but does it count as a horror
but
film?
There was around that time, there was this genre of films which was a lot like, every film was a lot like 100 Days, where, you know, there's this creepy stuff going on, somebody died from, and it was like the You Did Last Summer kind of vibe going on.
Full on, that was there.
Darna Manahe was scary, dude. Darna Manahe was actually
scary.
Like, there were one, two,
scary, the
for
one.
Me, like, it wasn't scary, but I loved that story of the dude who could point at people and say freeze, and then he looks at his reflection and he's frozen, and I'm like, that is proper, like, that is mind-bending horror. But yeah,
that was like a Twilight Zone episode.
Yeah,
that was literally like a Twilight Zone episode. That was great.
Nikhil from your chat said that Ragini MMS 1 was very scary. I agree. One I found very scary, bro. I know. I also feel
Are you serious or are you joking?
No, I'm serious.
No, somebody in this thing is saying.
No, I'm Jose saying that he found Ragini MMS.
I also found it scary, yeah. I'm not ashamed of what scares me. But, you know. But the thing I realized was that a lot of stuff we watched when we were younger, you watch it now, you're like, "Arey, that looks like a cardboard skeleton.
Yeah.
That's not scary."
But
what was scary is how it made you feel after you finished watching.
Yes.
So it was done, and then you're alone in the room, and then you
and
can
you're like,
hear,
"How I sleep now?"
Dude,
like, oh shit.
There was an Ahat episode where his eye popped out and they had put a table. Now that I saw it, it was a table tennis ball in half, okay, that they had put as the detached eye ball. But as a kid, I shat my pants.
Of course you did.
Stuff. Oh, very God. Of course you did. Scared beyond reason, you know.
I was terrified of Z Horror Show. Like, as a kid, like, that music inherently terrified me. Like, the music that Jose was just doing.
Yeah.
That was Ahat, I think. But they were
That was the horror show. Ahat had the cool synth music. The ting, 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 ting. With the bat and shit.
That's good.
With the bat and shit.
It's all merged for me.
Yeah, that was with the cool bat and shit.
Z horror show,
bro. Z horror show.
Now it's Z News Republic.
Oh, yeah, same thing.
Every time they are on.
The show got a channel now. और फिर उसने दरवाजा खोला और देखा कि नोट के अंदर GPS चिप था।
But as kids, though, really man, now you go back watch that stuff and you're like, what the?
Did you guys watch Wo? Did you guys watch Wo? Which was the Hindi remake of It?
There was an Hindi remake of It.
Bro, I think it was on Zee only, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong.
Not India.
Hindi. It was called Wo. All right, and it was a faithful ass fuck. Bomb ass show. Like, I watched Wo before I read It, okay, as a kid, and I remember, and genuinely, all right, well plotted, well episode by episode, finite fucking story over some 1998 episodes.
Z.
It was interesting, outstanding,
interesting.
It was so fucking good. Like, I remember, if I'm not mistaken, this guy was in it. Yeah, Ashutosh Govarikar was in it. If I'm not mistaken, as one of the characters.
I'm checking
the bunch of people in it.
But what's really unfortunate is that we can't watch that now and feel the same way as we would have felt when we watched it.
It's true.
When it came out. Like, even if someone's not watching, you watch it now, they'll be like, what the hell are these guys talking about?
Yeah, I mean, but, it's the same thing. Crazy. Like for example, like, there is a movie which is considered as the, like, greatest horror movie of all times, The Exorcist, right? If you watch it as a kid, you're like, your mind is messed up. Yeah. But now when people watch The Exorcist, they are like, yeah, I mean, cool. I don't know what you guys were losing your mind over it.
But I also feel like, for me, so Exorcist is on my list of favorite horror movies.
Oh yeah, by the way, sorry. Let's just start. Okay, Rohan, you have a list. You have a list that you wrote of horror movies.
I don't have a list that I wrote. I have a
rough
sort of...
You've got a rough this thing, right?
I've got a rough accounting. Wait, let me find that.
Which even Jose has. And right before, there was a list that I have written. So we all have a list. Someone in the league, I'm giving you responsibility, okay?
Of like compiling this list.
Yeah, and I think Newt, I'll give it to Newt Scamander because Newt Scamander comes for all our streams. Newt Scamander, this is your this thing, okay? You compile a list of all the movies and shows that we are talking about. We'll create the ultimate top 10 Binge O'Clock horror list. And Newt, you'll please do it. Please, please, please. Shout out to Newt Scamander for that.
He's like, "Hey, main kidhar phas gaya."
Yeah, really? Kahan pe hai?
Newt, we love you.
We love you, Newt.
Fantastic horror movies and where to find them. That is this thing. Vishaka said, yes. Friday and Saturday sorted now. Thursday stream, what fun. Well, thank you, Vishaka. Thank you. Okay. What was Exorcist was on all three our lists? Like, was that?
Yeah.
Exorcist was definitely on my list. Yeah.
Which I think has to be a phenomenal movie when you come to think about what went behind making it and the fact that they, I don't know if you know this, but they put subliminal images of the devil throughout the movie, which the audience didn't know would happen. Yeah, you didn't know that?
Really?
God, this is what's been traumatizing me.
There is a scene where she's on the bed and literally for a second, the face of the devil will flash like this white face with teeth and fangs and it'll do a fuck like that. It is subliminal throughout the movie. Like in how in Fight Club, there is a simple Tyler Durden this thing. The Exorcist had this scene happen. And it's quite a fascinating fact when you come to think of it.
That's crazy.
That is how they scare the audiences. No idea. The main girl, I forgot. Why do I always forget her? I was just remembering her name before.
That was Linda Blair, no?
Linda Blair. She was apparently scarred by the movie, I heard, because it kind of... It's
so, I don't know. I think that's like an... I think that's an urban legend. I could be wrong. But that used to be... So, that was... Yeah, before the internet, you had these conspiracy theories and chain mails that used to go around saying things like, the actor who played the girl in the film was so traumatized that she killed... It's all nonsense. Linda Blair is fine. Linda Blair grew up and hosted like a... like. True life paranormal this thing show everything Linda Blair theek hai kuch nahi hua Linda Blair ko Linda Blair ka life bahut sahi hai
but like
as far as I know
I felt like that that movie set the standard for like a good horror movie
also unlike a lot of other horror movies what The Exorcist did that was amazing at that time is it's one of the few it doesn't really rely on jump scares.
Yes.
It doesn't. It's pure build-up and atmosphere. You know, it's just this idea of... Because the amazing thing about the movie is also what's interesting about it is for this horror movie is it comes from the priest's side. He's just dropped into this world, right? And the book also on which it's based, the main entire point of the book in the movie is it's about a guy's crisis of faith.
Okay.
Basically, that's the story of crisis of faith.
Yeah.
And I just thought that build up, right, of that feeling trapped in that house with everything that's happening, plus his own mother's death that he's got this guilt about, that he keeps seeing, like, which at one point the demon also sort of communicates with him and like as his mother, if I'm not mistaken. And without going into spoilers, that ending.
Yeah, like, of course. I mean,
and same for the Omen series also. It was
same on my list. On my list.
That ending is the greatest. Like it is so eerie. It's not scary. It's eerie.
For you guys, not as scary as it was for people who are supposed to be Catholic when they were kids.
I was gonna ask, like both these movies, right? Actually, Exorcist and this thing, they're like religious horror.
Yeah.
And
your belief
kid,
system is tied into it, supposedly. You know what I mean?
Exactly
what you're saying.
Especially because the Exorcist...
This belief and this idea that the Antichrist itself can be born walking among us.
Yeah.
That must have been a fun one, Jose.
The Omen series really creeped us all out. Like, and I don't know if this was the same with y'all, but back in the day, everyone would come to one person's house because only one person had a TV
in
the building.
More importantly, one person had a VCR.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you huddle together for company, nah. So you can't watch it alone. You have all your friends to like watch it
you
together.
You also huddle together because the TV screen was 4 inches.
I remember people leaving and screaming, saying, I don't want to watch, I'm going home,
Baba.
We were all kids, we were in school watching this stuff. Why were parents letting us watch these films? I don't understand. But
it's a good
Omen
point.
Is some
it's
damn
a good point.
Creepy. Damn
yeah,
creepy.
Yeah, yeah.
Stuff.
My parents had this weird habit where they would decide that a movie was too scary for me. But because like I used to fight for, etc., they had this horrible habit where for some reason they'd let me watch the setup parts before the horror begins. It makes no sense. You know, like Jurassic Park.
Actually, it does
like
make sense.
As a kid, I swear to God, all right? As a kid, I thought Jurassic Park was this beautiful movie about this beautiful theme park full of dinosaurs that they make. Because right about the time in the movie in which it starts raining, I got sent to bed. Right? I got sent to bed. Right about the time it started raining, I got sent to bed.
Oh,
except
God.
My bedroom was not behind the TV. My bedroom was behind the sofa from which people were watching.
Oh.
So once I went inside and then popped my head out again, nobody knew. And I made the mistake of deciding to be a baller about this on the Omen.
Like, what?
And then I was like, now I understand why they want me to sleep.
Of course.
Jose,
of
did your
course.
Ear just fall off?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had a piercing. Live on stream, ghost. A ghost touched me and like, you know, Patrick Swayze touched my ear like that. Like, fucking hilarious.
Nice. We've covered The Exorcist. We've covered The Omen.
That Omen, that opening, that first scene only where that babysitter was like, baby Damien, I love you. And then she just throws herself off. I was like, what is happening in this movie?
Yo.
It's
and, you know, and like
it's...
and like Rohan said, they didn't rely on jump scares and stuff, but it was a lot of
atmosphere.
And they're like, build up. The child is Satan. Build up.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
But like,
surely someone will do that scene where he knocks his mom off the stool and the staircase.
She's trying to fix the chandelier or something.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
And he's on his tricycle and he just like...
Listen.
And such haunting images. Imagine the tricycle itself is not really scary.
Exactly.
But seeing that tricycle go off like that and him looking at his mom up there.
Exactly.
And her falling and all. Oh,
that
shit.
That kid's smile has to be the most evil smile. Like, it was
that's
so...
creepy.
Like, it was the... It's the same... It's the same thing, right? Like, I feel like there are these certain horror tropes that, like, now you have, but, like, back... Like, the thing with children in movies, right? I'm tired of seeing children in movies, but it works every single time, you know? Like, you have the twin sisters in The Shining.
Yeah.
You've got the girls giggling, you know? Randomly, there'll
but
be
But no, now,
playing.
Jose is an actual parent. So, he's like, in a horror movie, the movie would be scarier if you go around a corner and you see these two kids and they're real. Like, they're not ghosts.
But
they're
Papa,
real. And
but
you have to now parent them. And you now have to parent them.
I want to go for tuition.
Kids have this crazy habit of saying we have we have imaginary friends, or I can see someone standing in the corner over there. Oh, have you met my friend? They were looking at you last night. It's not my child. Anybody wants a child?
Not yet. Anybody want a child? Oh man, if you think that's scary, you should get a cat, Jose.
Yeah.
Because nothing can make your day more than when you're sitting and doing something and you look up and your cat is looking at something that's here. That's like just here. Like your cat's eyeline is for some reason just going.
Death note.
And it's like a stare, okay? It's like a conscious stare. It's like a. And you look
behind. The cat is like, let me screw them, I'll do this.
Yeah! It's fuck all! It's really
dude, that and there's a dog barking into thin air, you know, because every movie they show that if a dog barks, there is some shit going on. But like one night Bagel is just barking in thin air, and I'm like, this is just like this. So I'll give you a quick.
He's barking. Aray, Sai, you don't understand. He's barking at the ghost of the Pedder Road flyover, bro. जहाँ पे तू रहता है, he's barking at the ghost of the Pedder Road flyover that never was.
Lata Mangeshkar is patting him, saying, "You're a good boy. You're a very good boy.
Good dog."
So I'll tell you something. I'll give you a quick. I'm a very light sleeper, but when I sleep, I kind of hallucinate. Like I have this thing where when I wake up, I don't know what is reality. So there are so many times where I'll wake up and there's someone in my room, and I'll scream and I'll run to attack them, but there is no one. So stuff like that.
Meghna.
Yeah, it's
must be nice living with you.
Oh, Meghna.
What the hell?
It's a very sad life. But and the problem with this is that it also gets accentuated when I'm watching like a lot of horror movies, and I have seen so many of them that like just talking about this makes me. I know tonight this is going to happen.
100%. I'm going to have to watch some light comedy after this stream.
Yeah.
Just to sort of get sleep.
There is a movie that I want to talk about. There's a movie that I always talk about. I think someone in the chat earlier also had mentioned it. Omelette, I think his name is. A movie called Wreck, R-E-C, which I feel
should be the top. Oh, Wreck is supposed to be outstanding.
You've not seen it?
I haven't. No, but I've heard it's amazing.
It last time
Jose, you've still not seen it. No. Okay, guys. Everyone who is on this stream right now, if you haven't seen Wreck, you have... Very simple. Again, I'll give the quick pitch. It is a Spanish movie. It's basically found camera footage. There is a building, and it's they made an American version called Quarantine. It sucks balls. Okay, the Spanish version is very simple. Reporter, she gets a call. She goes to a fire station. Fire station suddenly gets a call that there's a building and there's a case in the building. So they run to the building, and suddenly 10 minutes later, the building is sealed, and everyone's trapped in the building, and the whole movie happens inside that building.
Ooh,
and there
nice.
there are two scenes in the movie that I'm not going to reveal, but there is one scene early on. The actors didn't know that the scene was going to happen.
That's fucked.
What?
That's fucked. Main director ko to chaata maarta uske baad.
Yeah.
How did you do that?
So the reactions that they gave were absolutely natural. And I want to tell you the scene, but I will ruin
it.
No, don't say anything. But I have seen that movie. The first time I saw it alone, lights out, and I said I will challenge myself to watch that movie. And I very rarely scream while watching movies, but I have yelled. Like, these are jump scares done properly. It's, oh man. For me, scariest movie of all time, Wreck. Like, scariest movie of all time.
Damn. Okay. I have to watch Wreck. Putting it on list right now. Putting it on list at once.
What would be your scariest movie of all time if you were to give me one?
So the thing is, you know what? I don't know if it counts as horror. I don't know. Are we counting slasher?
Yeah, of course. Slasher is horror. I mean...
Okay, then in that case, again, at the exact... So my sister's 6.5 years older than I am, which means when I was like an impressionable 11-year-old child, she was in college and she had college-age friends. Which means one night when my parents were out of town, some of her friends came over with the VHS of a movie that I had never heard of called Scream.
Oh, of course.
Right? And I've not, and this is before trailers and before the internet and before everything. And I'm like 10, 11 years old. And that first scene only, right? With Drew Barrymore. That first scene. And then you see that fucking guy with the mask. Okay. And I remember because essentially it was a bunch of 16, 17 year olds and me watching. Dude, the amount of screaming in that room, literally the amount of actual screaming. I don't think I've ever been part of a screamier experience. Then literally watching the movie Scream with my sister and her friends. when there were no adults in the house. And fucking slashers scared the shit out of me.
Of course. All slasher movies relied on the very, so like the very simple
formula.
Also, the
kills were beautiful. The kills were genuinely surprising and beautiful. Like
I was watching a video, an analysis of why Scream is such a good movie. And what happens was all the horror movies follow the same trope that there are a gang of people going through and the beautiful woman at the end survives. Scream changed
scene
it.
One.
Because
scene one,
she's
scene
dead.
One.
She's stabbed through.
This one's
going
to be your heroine. Yeah. That's Drew Barrymore. Surely she's your heroine.
But
boom.
That's
gone.
It. Gone.
Like just
dead.
Gone straight away.
So Scream was,
how many of those films did they make? 12.
Four.
And oh. now a series Checking. Also. Now they're
now
doing
a
series. Scream
series
also.
Now they're doing a series. But no, that first movie, even Scream 2 was outstanding. But Scream, that also, it was so, I'd never seen
Scream was
meta.
Brilliant, actually.
Meta, right? It was meta. It was the first, like, actually one of the first straight up meta mainstream movies that I ever saw, right?
Yeah.
The idea that these characters, like there was that guy who's watched every horror movie, right?
Yeah, and he keeps seeing the tropes again
and
again. And
he keeps pointing the, and the genius of that movie is, it will point out a trope, say, ye hone wala hai, phir wo hota hai aur gaad patti hai, phir bhi, but phir bhi fatta hai tera. Like, wo dekh ke bolke, phir bhi fatta.
And I think every film they would try to figure, they'd keep you guessing who
the
killer was.
They would shift up
the entire
sequence.
That was quite smart, I remember.
Scream was actually very smart.
Scream was outstanding and that terrified me. And that is one of my super scariest movies. And another one that has stayed with me because I saw it in the theater, which doesn't happen often. Like, it just happened now, but as a kid, horror movies, you didn't get a chance to watch so much in the theater. The Sixth Sense.
Sixth Sense won't come under horror.
What do you mean won't come under horror? It's literally about a guy who sees dead people.
I mean, yeah, but it's not like scary. Like,
it's
cool.
Scary. His first look, like when he doesn't understand what's happening to him, he has all these moments where once he's walking through his school, and he sees those three people hanging. Dude, I still remember that one scene where that kid comes to him and says, let me show you where my dad keeps his gun. And then he turns around and the back of his head is blown off. I don't think I've ever been terrified by any... Exactly. I don't think I've ever been terrified of any single shot in cinema. More than, because that is not a jump scare. There's no sound. There's no nothing.
Yeah, that was
it's
mad
just
cheeky.
A kid who turns around. That. And that whole story suddenly reveals itself and you're just like, ah. I'm getting goosebumps even now just thinking about it.
The Others was creepier than Sixth Sense, I'd say though.
The Others was great.
What was The Others? That was the Nicole Kidman
The Others
one,
was Nicole
right?
Kidman,
yes.
Yeah. It was really good.
That was good.
Watch it, but don't let people watch it. We shouldn't discuss it.
Yeah, we shouldn't discuss it.
The moment you start discussing
it,
you'll immediately end up giving the plot away.
Jose, what was your scariest movie?
Well, Sahil.
I know. It's a panel discussion. You know, welcome to the panel. Mr. Ho.
No. So, I think the first ever scary film you watched was The Exorcist.
Of course.
Because we were really young back then. And then you know what? A couple of years later, Leslie Nielsen did Repossessed. Have you ever seen that?
No, I haven't seen Repossessed.
I always talk about Repossessed. Bro, I can't find the film. I'm trying to find it. But basically, you know what he did? He just parodied the whole film. It is
That's
hilarious.
I have to
it
see
is
this.
You find trailers around on YouTube, I think. But he did Repossessed 1 and Repossessed 2, I think. Really funny. Anyway, but Exorcist, really scary. The Omen films, really, really scary. In the genre where there's no Satan and no ghosts and all, what really creeped the shit out of all of us was Jaws.
Ooh.
At the time. And everybody
yeah.
was getting together Jaws. And watching Jaws in one person's house. Jaws 1, though, oh my god.
Jaws 1 is terrifying.
Yeah, one of the girls in our building, she ran away after 15 minutes. She went up and she started screaming. And we had to stop. Everyone had to stop watching and all because there was a big disruption and all. They were like, oh no, I can't watch this enough. And I remember back then, it was even more creepy because...
What's dinner pe kya hai? Poplet.
The poplet jumps out of the plate. She's like, I don't like this anymore.
And it was even more creepy because back then there were these aquariums happening and all. And as a kid, you're imagining yourself... In one of the Jaws films, they take you into those big aquariums,
which then
breaks. Oh my god, just the thought of being eaten by a shark. I mean, it's not bhoot wala horror, but really, Jaws is the ocean, the unknown, and getting eaten while swimming. And as kids, we're like, we're just
That's
learning
what it is,
to swim.
Right? It's just the beach. Also, it takes, again, it's one of those things, right? The beach is supposed to be a place of frolic and joy, right?
Fun, yeah.
And
yeah.
it flips that. Suddenly in the water lurks this thing so that well can done. Fuck you so up. Well so done. Beautifully done. So beautifully
Jaws
done.
Jaws was incredible. And in those days to do a robotic shark on that
very
level.
Cool. Very,
yeah,
very cool.
Yeah. Yeah. Oof, very, good. Very, very cool. Also, Netflix has that movies that made us. I think Jaws is there. I think they talk about the animatronic shark and about how much of a pain in the ass it was or something like that.
Can only imagine, but damn creepy stuff. And then I think by the time the third film happened, that
people were like, "Hati ka, now I know." Yeah, 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 get it.
But still very creepy because you know they keep saying it's the biggest shark ever.
Yeah,
and the shark
gets
bigger and bigger and bigger. And then you're like, "I'm so small.
I'm
just gonna eat me like a hajmola."
Exactly.
So it got creepier and creepier.
Dude, in Jaws 4, they fucked up so bad. At one point, dude, the shark roars.
What?
Oh, yeah?
You can go check it out. Yeah, the shark. And it's known that sharks don't make sounds. Like it's scientifically known. But the shark roars. Like, this shark roars. Literally, the shark roars. What is your scariest film, Sahil Shah?
Okay, wait. Before I start, first things first, Rohit Balaji, thank you for the super chat. He said he gave a special mention to The Witch. I have not checked it out, but I will check
that
it out. Some people have listed a few other movies, 13 Ghosts, Hereditary and Sinister. They are scary movies.
13 Ghosts was pretty scary.
13 Ghosts was a great
that,
movie.
Yeah.
Another movie I saw as a kid and it freaked me out because there's that one ghost that does... That head moving, there's that motion blur that they used to do.
Just suddenly show up in front of you and go,
it freaked the heck out of me. Now, I'm going to...
Understandable.
I already said my scariest movie was Wreck, but I'm going to, since you're talking about slashers, I have to mention two, okay? Obviously, Friday the 13th has special place in my heart because my mom had told me she was scared of that movie when she saw it, and then one day I was watching it.
Your thumbnail,
Sal. Huh? Yeah, of course. We'll come to that guy also. That is Freddy Krueger, Nightmare on Elm Street. He is scary, but in a very fun way. In a very around or I'm in your dreams and I'm like, like that way.
Yeah.
Friday the 13th, what a great movie because the first movie ended with the greatest jump scare ending ever, right? Where she's, and this is now, it's an old movie, so I can give
you a spoiler. Now it's fine. You can give
she
it.
She survived the massacre. She's chilling in the boat and she's just in an empty lake and the camera is on a wide frame. And she's just, and it slowly zooms in, and out of nowhere, a hand comes out and grabs her. Oh!
And then that became the go-to horror movie trope of all horror movies, where you think you're safe, and at the end, there's one.
My God!
There will be a sequel.
My God!
Yeah, there will be a sequel.
And I think that's what the beauty of those old slasher movies were, like Halloween, Nightmare on Elm Street. You've got
the Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Texas Chainsaw. Those unbreakable villains where you can kill them, hit them, but there's nothing that's going to do to break them.
What film series was that? Where was it The Hills? Where they people were inbreeding and then they
the
became crazy
the
creatures.
The Hills Have Eyes.
Oh, that scared the shit. I'm getting chills thinking about that. Imagine being
that
in some remote place and these people are they unkillable and they keep and but they're also sentient. Oh my God, messed up shit.
I want to use that as a jump off point. About to pitch another one of my scariest movies of all time. This idea of being in an unknown place. And suddenly getting attacked. Have you guys seen Neil Marshall's The Descent?
Of course.
Like, that again is one of my all-time scariest movies. Like, The Descent. Just the claustrophobia, right? So, it's basically about four friends who go spelunking in a cave underground. And then the whole movie happens in the underground cave. And that's all I'll say. And it is...
It's
so scary. It is so scary. It is so scary.
I love these there is another movie I'm trying to, if leak, if you remember, it's very similar to The Descent where basically they explore the Paris catacombs. Okay. And it is just like, it is all underground. It's the same line of descent, underground, random scenes of random things happen and suddenly they don't happen. Like you take a turn, you see a sacrifice, you turn around, it's not there, stuff like that. But Descent is, it was in my list.
That's so above, so below. Says omelet.
Yes.
So above, so below.
That was the one. Yes. Please do check it out.
The descent or the dissect? The descent.
As above,
the descent.
Descent.
As in going down. The descent. Like going down. Okay. So above, so below.
and
has to be picked up as well.
We've added to the descent. I'm going to mention one movie which I think is the creepiest movie I've ever seen. So one of my favorite horror directors is Mike Flanagan. He was the guy who made Haunting on Hill House. Rohan, did you finally watch it?
I finished the fuck out of it.
It's
probably not best for my sanity that I sat and watched it in Amsterdam.
You were in Bhopal. Don't lie to us.
I was in Bhopal. I watched it in Bhopal. I watched it in goddamn Bhopal. And yeah, Mike Flanagan is great. But which movie?
So before he did Haunting on Hill House, and I was telling Jose also, Haunting on Hill House has a fascinating thing that in almost every 5 minutes in every scene, he has hidden a ghost in the background.
When you
watch it, you're watching the show, and then when you rewind and you start watching it, you'll see this one arm. There's a scene where behind the door there are just two people.
There's just
staring.
Two people watching. Yeah. It's that show is astonishing. Like I'm also halfway through Midnight Mass right now. And it's great.
I have to definitely check out Midnight. So someone mentioned
Haunting of Hill House was stunning. I'm so glad I watched it.
Who is this under the chat? Vishnu AN. Yes, my buddy. You are the guy. It's called Hush. Hush is available on Netflix. Have you guys seen Hush?
Okay, no, I'll check it out.
Okay. Very simple premise. There is a girl. She's alone in a cabin and she's an author. So she's writing
deaf,
a book,
right?
And she's deaf.
Very creepy film.
And out of nowhere, there's a guy who's trying to kill her, but because she's deaf,
She doesn't see it.
That's it. That's
amazing.
It's very just creepy. So creepy. It is so creepy. Like the more you watch it, you're like, I don't want to be.
Hush with Katie Siegel. Hey, isn't that the same one who plays Theo on?
She's in every Mike Flanagan show. She's even
Midnight
Mass.
She's also
like,
in Midnight Mass.
He's like this thing. But
she's his mascot.
Hush was great. Please do watch Hush. Please go.
No. I'm just looking over at my list. We've done Scream, we've done Exorcist, we've done Omen, Hereditary. Hereditary. That movie just tore me
all time.
Up.
Yeah.
Like that movie just tore me up and I was just like, I need baths, I need lights, I need many things. I need many.
Hereditary didn't mess me up as much as Midsommar did. Midsommar was one where I was like, okay, have you seen Midsommar?
No, not yet. Because
exactly.
After Hereditary, I'm like, next year. I'm like, you know what, next year, it's fine. Because the thing that fucked me up completely about Hereditary is how deep it burrows into that idea of that mental illness being passed on. Right? And it just, and what then it does with that sort of metaphor. And also, there's some horror movies that are like The Exorcist is all atmosphere, right? And then there are some movies that are all imagery. And the imagery in Hereditary will just... Okay, it's that same thing, right? Like you know how like Haunting of Hill, the idea there's always a ghost back. Dude, Hereditary is just full of... Dude, like these people watching from behind.
Yeah.
And those creepy people at the funeral. And I'm not even going to say it without any spoilers, but that scene where they're driving back home and everything that happens after, right? Nothing could have prepared me for that. Nothing could have prepared me.
Rojo, please see Midsommar.
It's that level of creep only.
It's the same guy. And it's
I
like,
know this. Ari Aster.
Beautiful. Beautiful level of creep.
He's just fucked up.
Dude, Hereditary, the scene where he...
like this.
He hits his head on the desk also was a fucked up scene.
Out of nowhere that happens.
And I'm like, what am I watching, dude? This is like...
It was
like
horrific.
Rohan was saying films that mess with your head. This one film that after watching, then you're sitting alone in a room, and when this is a film that'll mess with you, won't let you sit alone in any room anyway.
Mm-hmm,
you guys
remember
the John Cusack film 1408?
Of course, based on one of the best Stephen King short stories.
It was a mad movie.
I saw it in the theater.
Oh my god.
Saw it in the theater when it first came out.
I saw it on a television and man, after that you're just like always looking around your room.
Yeah.
You're not sure.
Yeah.
Like you're just not sure.
Hotel rooms after that
anymore.
For a bit, you're just like,
super creepy.
Yeah, that's the beauty of all these sort of movies, right? Each one introduces a brand new element of things that you have to be afraid of, and then something like Final Destination comes and make you afraid of everything.
Everything.
You know, I'm like, I didn't go to SL World for a year after
SL that. World. Bhai, main Final Destination 2 dekhne ke baad Western Express highway pe nahi gaya 4 saal. Kya baat kar raha hai tu?
Bro,
Pune nahi gaya 4 saal.
After that film, every time I was on the road and I'd see a truck with those dundies sticking out.
Till date.
If I see a truck with logs, I'm like, either go as far back as possible or get ahead of it as far as
you know, I randomly look at screws when I'm like, I'll look at something and I'll just see whether the screw is tight. Can the screw be loose?
Is it
going to fall off? Expressway, yes, but till date, I'm not even kidding. That same thing that you said about Dundee's, that scene just again and again and again plays out. Even flights.
One of the greatest action sequences of all time, in my opinion. The opening of Final Destination 2 is, for my money, one of the all time best put together
brilliant
action
sequences.
Ever.
Dude, I
like you saying all, Sahil was saying all these films introduce something new for you to be scared of, and then Final Destination makes you scared of everything. The Freddy Krueger series made you scared of going to sleep. Of course, it was more of a fun
now
slasher.
Your dreams, but still now but your
it was
dreams
all about,
it is, it
yeah.
is a weird, it is a very...
A lot of the catch line was like, they're telling people don't go to sleep. If you go to sleep, some shit's gonna go down and stuff, so please don't go to sleep.
Jose,
don't go to sleep, my friend. I will come to you.
On that note, by the way, everyone
who is
watching.
What's your skincare routine, bro? What's your skincare routine?
Oh, yeah. Please.
It's just fire and hell. And hellhounds peeing on your face. That shit was crazy.
People watching, please like the stream. If you're enjoying the conversation, like the stream. I have made some mentions about you guys.
Likes,
Sagar Utkarsh, thank you for the super chat. Starting time in Midsommar. Yeah, definitely we will talk about it. Don't Breathe is not scary per se. It's an interesting. Saw is also... Then you go into the gore territory. That doesn't go into the horror situation, you know. Someone has mentioned something, Bhagya D, and I think I had mentioned that in my list. We have to talk about the first Conjuring movie.
Oh, yeah.
The Conjuring.
The Conjuring. Terrifying. James Wan. Freaking terrifying, dude.
That scene where she's there and near the cellar, you know, like... And out of nowhere, the hands come and the lights go off.
Yeah, that movie was messed up. Like, in the summer, it's one of those movies, again, where the first 10 minutes only, you're just like, oh, I'm so uneasy already.
I don't know.
I don't know that I want to be here. I have no idea that I want to be here.
What I enjoy about movies like this, right? Like, it was like, if you look at so many movies, all these, a majority of the horror movies have an inspiration from something in real life. Like, for example, Texas Chainsaw Massacre was based on Ed Gein. He used to, he had a...
He literally
a lamp made out of human skin, a belt made out of nipples. It was the weirdest thing ever. Yeah, he would kill them and then make furniture.
He was the original. He was the original Govinda. Govinda
made out of
nipples. Govinda before Govinda.
Belt
made of nipples.
Sitting there going, tu mera nipple
number one.
Nipples is the funniest thing I've heard in a long time.
Hey, we missed Sagar Utkarsh's super chat.
Sagar Utkarsh, what was Sagar Utkarsh super chat? I spoke to Sagar Utkarsh right now. I think we missed Rhythm super chat, who said Autopsy of Jane Doe. I don't know. I've not seen that movie. I apologize. Oh. Autopsy of Jane Doe. We will definitely check it out. I was talking about some movie right now. Texas Chainsaw, and I was talking about...
Based on real things you were saying. So Texas Chainsaw was one of them, based on Ed Gein.
Yeah. Before that,
also, like, just while we're on the subject, the first Evil Dead movie.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
You know,
Sam Raimi.
The first of all the films were so great.
No, even Evil Dead 2 was great, because he literally remade Evil Dead 1, but with a whole different perspective. That's all Evil Dead 2 was.
Groovy.
That was
groovy.
Damn
creepy. I used to, for years after watching, I watched all three Evil Dead movies on a VCD I found in Colaba. There was one of those VCD DVDs that had all three on it, and I watched all three back to back. And Sahil, like you did, I did that Bruce Campbell imitation for like 3 years.
It's a great imitation. By the way,
while we're on the subject, have you guys fucking seen the TV series
Ash vs. Evil Dead? Of course,
it's so good.
It is a lot of fun.
I started
it's
watching.
So good. It's great fun.
It is actually a lot of fun. I remembered what I was talking about, by the way, since we were talking about real people. The Amityville Horror also is based on a real life story. And
the
Conjuring series gets creepier when you realize it's based on a real life story. There is a real life Annabelle doll locked away somewhere that cannot be opened. And I'm curious. And like, do you believe in it, or do you think it's, you know, like it gets into that zone. Like, you want to open it, but you're like, agar kuch ho gaya toh.
I don't want that to happen. I have no problem. Like, the population density makes it physically impossible to be scared.
Of course, for the ghost,
all I have to do is run for 4 seconds and I will run into another human being. Like, that's it. Okay.
Proper super chats.
Super chat party.
Charan Bhagavatula, I hope I pronounced your name right, said BuzzFeed Unsolved Supernatural is fun. Yes, that is a lot of fun. It's two guys visiting random case files and they were talking about that. The best one is, you should check the Elise Lam one, the girl who went into the lift and disappeared. I'll explain later. Aniket Savant said Indian cinema Tumbad and 1920. Tumbad is a great movie. It is a very good
Tumbad
movie.
Is good, yeah.
Very, very well made, very eerie. Have you seen Tumbad, Rohan?
No, it's Anand Gandhi, no?
No. Tumbad was
it's on
Soham
Prime,
Shah. He
Soham
directed
Shah,
and
Soham
acted
Shah.
In
it
also.
Got it.
Fantastic movie.
It's on Prime, you said.
On Prime.
Check it out.
Sagar Dhote said, watch the first Conjuring alone at 3:30. Why? That also an Inox Malad.
Oh, he was a Dolby consultant then.
Okay.
Jesus Christ.
Malad.
Oh, shit, dude. There was a story of ghosts at the same mall. We'll try narrating it in the next ghost story. Listen, Inox Malad already has got me hooked. That's all. You don't need anything anymore.
Yeah, Malad also done. Good ghost stories from there.
Rhythm again.
Rhythm says Autopsy of Jane Doe is hell scary.
Okay, we'll watch the trailer.
Anurag Nair says, check out this Iranian movie Under the Shadow.
Under the Shadow. Very interesting.
Very, very interesting. We'll check it out.
And the Black Phone.
The Black Phone is going to be super dope. Can't wait. That's
the Ethan Hawke one where he kidnaps people, and the basic premise is that he kidnaps a kid and the kid is lying there. And when the kid wakes up, suddenly he realizes that all the previous ghosts of the kids that have been murdered by this guy are there in this thing trying to help him escape. That's the basic premise. So
that's pretty
it'll
cool.
be interesting.
That's heartwarming, actually.
That's oddly inspiring.
The Others was a good movie. Yes, we have discussed it. Wow. Now, suddenly.
Yes. Somebody put it in there, so we may as well address it. No love for The Shining. All the love for The Shining.
Please.
I love The Shining.
Of course.
I love The Shining. I love the book.
Even
I
Misery.
Love the movie. Misery.
Misery
also.
Is also such a
Misery
good movie.
Misery is terrifying. Brilliant. Misery, the book Brilliant. Also, all kinds of terrifying.
And you know, in those times, they really would not rely on showing you scary shit. They would just take you to mad premises. Just let your mind fill in all the gaps.
But
that was really creepy. You drive yourself insane.
Shining is one of those movies where you realize as a writer, yeah, it could happen.
Oh, 100%.
It could. If I'm locked alone 100%. For a very long time and I'm constantly disturbed, I'll go crazy. I'll be like, let me do
that
this tweet.
When she breaks his legs.
Oh, in Misery, no? Yeah.
That
and the penguin, she's like, who? That's like, you know, people who living at home, like, who moved this penguin 2 degrees? I'm going to break your
Dude,
legs.
But that was filled with so much anxiety watching that
did
movie.
Did you know that Stephen King apparently had an alternate ending for the book? In On Writing or something, he talks about it, where, if I remember correctly, the alternate ending that he didn't go with, that he had for the book, is that essentially a couple of weeks or months after the events of the movie, you sort of just see her alone at home and she's got the copy of the book that he's written.
Okay.
Except that the copy, she's like, it's such a beautiful copy that the cover doesn't look like leather. That's not leather. What is it? What is the book cover made of?
Ooh.
And it just sort of leaves you with the idea that she used his skin to make the book. Like,
that was dark.
And he's like, beyond a point, he's like, there's like, people would have killed me because there's dark and then there's that.
That is
and so,
dark.
Yeah. That was one of the thoughts he apparently had, like, for the ending of it, which is freaking terrifying.
I'll show you this, okay, guys? This is a purchase I made recently. And this,
beautiful.
For me, is my proudest poster because it's got all the horror movie characters we've spoken about. You've got your Ash, and more importantly, there you have little Annie.
Yeah, there you go.
So you've got,
it's got Pinhead from Hellraiser.
Of course, Hellraiser was great.
Hellraiser was great.
You've got, I mean, when I'm like, I'm just looking at this and I'm like, aur kya bhool gaye? But Hellraiser, again, very weird movie. Very like,
extremely weird.
A movie that we have to talk about, by the way. Quick super chat from Abhishek saying, let's discuss Insidious 2, please. Jose, the guy who successfully broke anti-Balesh system. Oh, thank you, Abhishek. And huge fan of all three. Thanks again, Abhishek. Insidious is the same zone as Conjuring. But yeah, some good, very... Have you seen Insidious?
I have not seen Insidious.
James Wan has managed a very simple formula. So with James Wan, he's done a very simple... His horror is very simple. You'll be looking in one direction, ghost will be either behind you, or you turn around and you turn back, ghost is in front of
you.
That's his entire series. So Insidious plays a lot with that. Oculus.
Akshat Mithya saying you all miss Radhe. Hilarious.
Of course, Akshat. Of course. That will be the top of our list. Otherwise, we are not going to. That and Suryavanshi.
Of course. Dude, Suryavanshi scared the shit out of me as a kid. Suryavanshi really scared me as a kid, okay? I didn't know better back then. And this is the idea that he gets dreams of a past life and all this. Listen, fuck you, Suryavanshi was very scary, okay? It's not my fault. Your imaginations are limited and they didn't run away with you all. But I'm sorry, Suryavanshi is very scary.
We have discussed 13B. We've discussed all of that. Yeah, special mention. I mean, now that someone has mentioned it, I think we obviously have to talk about... Guys, Japanese and Korean horror is just...
It's next level. I have it on my list. I have not brought it up yet. It is written here proudly, Ringu.
Ringu, I mean...
Ringu and Ju-on. Like, just... Ringu and Ju-on. I watched those movies and they destroyed me and they tore me up. There was another movie called The Eye.
Yeah.
Which was also terrifying.
Yeah.
And... Yeah.
Was Ju-on was The Grudge, right? Ju-on was grudge. Remade as The Grudge, right?
Ju-on was The Grudge. Man. Oh, man. Such... That movie destroyed me.
Like, they know what to do, you know, like, they...
Like, I don't know what it is about the Japanese, where it's like, they know exactly which button of creep to push. Like,
yeah,
in an oddly specific, God. It's almost like, it's like a kind of, like, it's like, you know, the Vulcan nerve pinch? Like, it's like the horror version of that. They're like, they know exactly push this specific out. Button, and it's just going to fuck up your day for some reason, and you won't be able to explain
it. I was talking to someone about this recently, like Omelette. Dude, Omelette, whoever you are, I need to meet you. We've got fantastic tastes in movies. There's a movie called Pulse, okay?
Yes.
And I was watching a video essay as to why there is one scene which is this a super scary scene. Why? Because, A, there is... Okay, now I have to talk about this scene because it was very fascinating. So what happens is he looks up and he sees a woman in the shadows. The woman ka top half is in the shadows, bottom half is in sunlight. There is no jump scare. There is no music. There is no sound effects. You know what is scary? She starts walking towards him. But rather than walking normally, she'll take two steps. Then she'll slant. Then she'll slide and she'll walk two steps. So the walk itself is so unnatural.
It's so disorienting.
It is so disorienting. Just that, if you watch that Pulse ka scene afterwards.
But great way to avoid sandworms. You know, if you walk in that irregular pattern, you know, very, very good way to avoid sandworms. So I have to say, this ghost.
Hey, Tremors was also in that zone.
Tremors was also there.
Yeah.
Somebody else pointed out another one that is an absolute classic and should get some love is The Thing.
Of course.
Kurt. Freaking Russell, and what a terrifying, again, right, claustrophobia. Just this idea of you are trapped in the ice with all of these people, and there's this thing, and now figure it out.
A beautiful ending also, na? Very yeah, beautiful ending. Where
it's the most bittersweet ending in horror, right, they call it. Right?
Yeah.
Because it's like you've defeated the this thing, but if you pause for 2 minutes to wonder about what the fate of the characters will be anyway, it's quite sad.
It is, like, it is.
Yeah.
One of the movies that I also want to recommend, since we are talking about this, I just wrote it over here. It's an old movie. I don't know if you guys have seen it. It's called Jacob's Ladder.
Dude, are you kidding? Of course I've seen Jacob's Ladder. That movie fucked me. It was one of the first movies that I saw that had like very weird, unexplainable imagery, right? Where it's not just about ghosts and this, that. It's like, ye kya ho raha hai? Iska life normal lag raha hai, lekin aisa ek kabad ke peeche aise saap jaisa kuch hai.
Jose, I'm giving you a list of things. You have to see Jacob's Ladder also.
You've got to watch Jacob's
there
Ladder.
There are scenes that are just so...
Fucked up.
It's the same
that
you're
looking for.
You know that head, like that scene which they do, and you're like, I don't know what I'm watching. Why am I watching something like this?
Ooh, now that you brought it up. Another movie that for some reason very hard to find. But again, I randomly watched it as a kid because I'd seen the trailer. Messed me up. I think it's a John Carpenter movie only. It's called In the Mouth of Madness.
Okay.
All right. And it's got Sam Neill, who basically plays this writer / investigator who goes to investigate some strange claims in this strange. And again, it's just surreal and fucked up imagery. Like really, really screwed up imagery. And it's just one of those movies where by the end of it, you're just uneasy as hell. Like, you just, something inside you just feels twisted and weird. And you're just like, I need some sunlight and I need to walk it off. Like, I really need to
So that's why I'm saying now, like, your movies fall into different zones, right? As you discussed, we've got the scary movies that remind you of something. We've got the movies that you don't want to visit places afterwards. And then you've got movies with imagery like this. There was a movie called Cannibal Holocaust that was banned. It wasn't a scary movie, but
gore.
It was pure gore. So I don't want to talk about even Hostel.
For me, the worst are the ones that... The worst movies are the ones set up in your homes.
Yeah.
Because that's where we are the most.
When fear comes home, right? That's the idea always. Yeah.
That is,
that's what's terrifying, right?
And that's, I think that's how you discuss Paranormal Activity.
Hey, no.
But like,
Paranormal,
is that a
I don't
movie?
Know why
is that
people
a
say Paranormal is scary.
Is that a gimmick?
The
is
first
that a...
one was, the first one was super creepy, bro. I found it extremely creepy. It started getting a little like, it was the same thing, I guess, the next few films. But the first one was way creepy. Especially the way they... That was the first time they did it like that. No,
Blair Witch was before
that. The cameras.
Blair Witch was before that.
No. This is the first
Blair
time
Witch
they
was
did
handheld
CCTV
camera.
Footage.
CCTV.
Yeah,
footage.
CCTV footage,
yes,
the
yes,
first
yes,
ever. Made
yes.
that really, really creepy. And they'd show you bodies going past the room.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Oh my God. That shit.
No, it was scary for
that,
sure.
That creeped
it was
me out.
Scary for sure.
Have you seen Blair Witch, Jose?
Yes, of course. My God, that was also
Blair Witch scared
much.
The shit out of me. Just because, again, just stretching build up, right? Like how you can just stretch build up into like that movie. You scare. It's one of those rare movies where you scare yourself because you're just like, oh, kuch hone wala hai, kuch hone wala hai, kuch hone wala hai, kuch hone wala hai. You scare yourself in that.
Like with Blair
that
Witch,
made you stop. That made you be scared of treks.
Yeah.
Like, oh, I don't want to go on a trek now. Now for one
I
year,
will,
no treks,
dude,
please.
One second. Horror movies have taught me that America may outside of a crowded city, main kidhar nahi jayega. Main kidhar nahi jayega. Main suburban America nahi jayega kyunki Amityville horror ho jayega. Main America mein aisa kisi bacche ka ghar nahi jayega kyunki Exorcist ho jayega. Main America mein trek mein nahi jayega kyunki Blair Witch Project ho jayega. Main America mein cave spelunking nahi jayega kyunki Descent ho jayega. Main America, mere ko, you know what, America jane ka hi nahi. Like, I think मेरे को नहीं जाने का
अमेरिका नहीं जा सकता जापान नहीं
जापान
जापान नहीं जा सकता इंडिया में we've got 13B as usual that's a building so India is also totally out so that's it we are completely ruining everything
there's nowhere to go
yeah I'm just googling to see by chance Dutch horror movie है क्या अगर Dutch horror movie नहीं है तो वहाँ जाते यार
to space also there are horror movies someone had mentioned Event Horizon,
what a great movie.
But like, and okay, let's see. Now let me go, Jose, go through your list. Tell me if you have anything that we have missed out.
No, we discussed everything from my list, fortunately.
Yeah, we have, everything even I'm going there. Through my list. I'm seeing if I've missed out anything.
I have one, again, just because it's the metaest and the bestest. Cabin in the Woods.
Oh yeah.
Cabin in the Woods. Have you seen Cabin in the Woods, Jose?
Yes, but you know what really scared me as a kid was Pet Sematary.
Yes, again Stephen and, King Max.
And we had the book at home.
Listen, I'm a little worried about your childhood right now. You know, like
you know what my mom was trying to do. She's like, you need to be afraid.
Yeah, clearly.
But Pet Sematary was really creepy, bro. One of the creepiest things.
Pet Sematary was very creepy. I agree.
Sticks with you.
I agree. It really sticks with you. Also, like, it's again, one of those, there's that, again, it's a specific kind of horror, right? Where someone dealing with tragedy tries to make things better and makes tragedy worse is a great horror genre. And Pet Sematary is like full on. Somebody's also pointed out The Mist while we're talking about Stephen King recommendations.
Of course. I mean, but that's what I'm saying. Now that's what I'm saying, right? You have a territory of scary movies and you have a territory of what the fuck just happened. And The Mist comes in that zone, you know, because comes in that. You know, would you consider Solaris as a space horror?
No, I'd call that more of a psychological / philosophical like this thing than a space horror. Like it feels more like that. Like for sure.
7 days? 14 days? What is that zombie?
28 days later.
28 days.
Very good.
28 days later. Very good film.
That was very good. And they did a couple of different versions also, no? There was the first film, then the second film. Oh man. 28 weeks really
later
well
was the second
28
film.
Weeks. I was obsessed with those films for some time.
This guy, what's his name?
Brilliant.
Danny Boyle.
Brilliant stuff.
There are very few good zombie movies. And I feel 28 Days was one of those where I was like, hey, you know, this I actually like.
Oh, damn.
Are we also doing zombie really movies? Good. Are we also doing zombie movies?
Man, if I, yeah, of course. I, okay.
Then
I'm,
Train to Busan.
Train to Busan.
I mean,
Busan
come on.
Was damn
Train to
good.
Busan,
damn
bros.
Fucking good. So good. So fucking
Train
good.
To Busan.
And you know, maybe people laugh at this, but I found I Am Legend also really fucking good. And
I
had the
good.
Book somehow. Somehow
yeah,
I had
I have,
the book
have
also
the book.
At home. I loved it. And in and the book is way better than the film.
Yeah, the book
I
is way,
the
way,
film.
Way better.
I love
better.
The film, but the book is the book really puts crazy images in your head of.
And the book
and
ending
were,
is outstanding.
Yeah, and there's an alternate ending for the film also.
Yes.
But the
yes.
but the in the book, if I remember, the zombies were kind of sentient.
Yes. Yes.
That also leads into this alternate ending or whatever. But in the book, they're waiting for him outside and screaming
yeah,
for
yeah,
him
yeah,
and
yeah,
shit.
Yeah.
Oh
Full on.
My god, bro.
It's, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes.
I have to mention this since we are talking about zombies. I mean, I know it's not a movie, but all three of us play games. And I just have to say Resident Evil as a series has
oh,
to
of
be
course.
The best and scariest games I've ever played.
Silent Hill, bro. The first few Silent Hill games. Don't forget those guys.
Yeah, those
In
were...
just terms of pure, again, Japanese, right? Freaking Japanese. Silent Hill was Japanese, right? And it's just these, the imagery. Like, while it's a Resident Evil, zombies, jump scares, etc. Silent Hill, each monster is only so disorienting and surreal and weird. It's just, again, it's just that unsettling, creepy yeah. feeling from the start, right? Like with Silent Hill.
Yeah, yeah. Silent Hill, there was this, okay, I'll tell you, great, great game, okay? This, it was called Left 4 Dead, okay? I don't know if you'll ever
oh,
play
yeah,
Left 4
Dead. Oh, yeah, of course,
Left 4
Dead. Yeah, 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 yeah.
So, Left 4 Dead, Jose, you ever played Left 4 Dead?
Of course, bro. One
so,
and two.
My favorite part of Left 4 Dead was the witch, okay? And the witch was a very simple
oh,
character. You'd be walking
creepy.
Around, and in the corner, you'd hear...
You could hear her. And she could hear her crying. Oh my god.
And you, the first time, I'm like, who's crying? I'm like, innocently, maybe someone's crying, I will help them.
Second time, cry. You just cry. You just cry. I don't care.
Then there was the boomer. The boomer. You shoot at him and he would explode.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Left 4 Dead, obviously. Last of Us, obviously. Yes, all of us have played Last of Us. And
ooh.
That goes into, again, it's horror slash a different territory, but yeah.
So, Dipali Pankaj has brought us to a very interesting place.
Yes.
Because I would like to talk about the single scariest experience I've had in terms of media consumption. Was not a movie.
Okay.
Not a show.
Okay.
Not a book.
Okay.
It was a play called The Woman in Black, which has since been turned into a movie with Daniel Radcliffe. Etc. But The Woman in Black is actually a play. So you can go, it is one of the longest running plays in the world. It still runs on the West End in London in the 90s, because that's how old I am. In the 90s, they had come down, sorry, in the early 2000s, they had come down for like a special tour. So that was my first reaction. A play. How can a play be scary? It's a play, like you're sitting with 500 people stage pe ora, you can see people coming
yeah.
and going. But no joke, the single most terrifying, well-produced, you can go today, the next time you're in London, I urge you to go watch The Woman in Black.
Okay.
You will come out so terrified and so dazzled at the fact that somehow you were terrified by this play. There's one scene, again, I'm not going to spoil it, I'm not going to whatever, but there's one particular scene in the play where I was watching so intensely that... Which, like every horror movie and, you know, every horror scene has a build-up, like a song, right? There's a build-up and then there's a drop, right? Dude, when what you can call the drop in that scene happens, I'm not ashamed to say, in a room full of 600 people...
You yelled?
I just went... And not just yelled, it was a straight-up little baby six-year-old... just like a straight-up whole audience turned to look at me type vibe. But I was terrified. I was
like,
very
it's
terrified.
Sir,
and that
play,
dude, that play is beautiful. And one of the most beautiful things about it is, all right, like, you know, at the end of every play, they have like a curtain call. Right?
Yeah.
Where the actors come out, do their thing, this, that, whatever. It's like a really nice, jolly curtain call, etc., whatever. And then at the end, like when the lights are going down, etc., they don't do a curtain call for the actual woman in black. And then just as the lights are going down and the curtain call is over, you see her standing up in the one corner of the stage. Like, just as the lights go down, just looking
oh
down
God.
At you. I know, udhar bhi kaan phat gaya. Like, udhar bhi kaan phat gaya. Like, matlab, tum log kya kar rahe ho? Curtain call mein bhi phat diya. Tum log kya kar rahe ho? Literally. And oh man, it
like,
was
everyone's like, oh wow, Rohan's giving a standing ovation, he's running. You know,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
okay, bye, bye guys. Bye.
I am out of this place.
They're like, sir, the show is not over, the standing ovation in a little while. He's like,
no, no, enough for me. It's enough for me. Rhythm says, have you watched Raat? Yes, Raat was a great movie.
Raat was also damn good. Wow,
Raat was
so many
very,
gems
very good.
Being like dropped, yeah?
Yeah. I've not seen Raat. This is a...
Really?
It's an eye-opening. Again, Raat...
Raat was RGV, no?
When Raat came in 1992. Yeah.
Was Raat RGV? I think it was RGV.
Yeah.
I was
born in 1991, guys. So for me, I think it was
school at that
real
time.
Quick. No, I wasn't even going to school. I was
yeah,
just
Ram
real
Gopal
quick. Ghost Ship, Shutter, PMAC, hashtag Alive. Yeah, I've seen Alive. Why is everyone asking Jose ko kya? Jose, what is happening to you, man? Everyone's like,
oh my
really
god,
upset.
I'm very disturbed. I read a weird comment and I'm just kidding. I'm fine. I was just dealing with some chats.
Happy Thanksgiving. Happy
Thanksgiving,
guys. I think we've
happy
covered
Thanksgiving. The history of Thanksgiving, you know, is of course the real
that
horror
is
story.
A beautiful horror story.
True horror story.
That is ultimate home invasion when you come to think of
yes,
it.
Yes, max
know?
Home invasion. Oh most
god.
Home invasion.
Dude, there's
like
a
ever.
Very creepy movie hey, I
was...
have to talk about. Sorry, Jose, talk.
No, no, I'm saying that was another genre of really freaky shit. Man, you're so right. They were just trying to take away all our safe spaces. Home invasion was another genre of film that was too
so
creepy.
I'll tell you what, if I can figure out the name, again, League, help me out. It's very simple. It was based on the Roman Polanski, his wife got murdered by the Manson
Rosemary's
family.
Baby, right?
Not Rosemary's Baby. But, Roman Polanski, basically his wife, Sharon Tate and a bunch of them are in the house and people enter the house and they're all wearing masks and then they torture them and murder them through and...
So it's about the Manson family. Like,
it's inspired by the Manson family. It's not Helter Skelter. It is. I'll, if I find the name, I will let you guys know. Oh man,
do.
That was a
please
scary
do.
Movie, man. That was. A,
please do.
They all wear masks. It is one of those. It's okay. Let me see. If I'll find it out and I'll tell you guys. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But Rosemary's Baby also very scary.
Rosemary's
Corn.
Baby. Corn. Hey, Corn can't be scary, guys. Come on, yeah. I saw it recently. I'm like, shut up.
Hey, Corn was very scary. Please. Again, saw it
it's
in the theater.
Bro.
It was very scary. Corn was very creepy, okay? Fuck that.
Children of the Corn.
Children of the Corn. I was a child of the Corn.
I think we've covered it, guys. If y'all have any other records, leak, please let us know. I think we are almost
done.
I think
all
we've
my
covered
main
everything.
Ones.
Yeah,
my Scream, Exorcist, Omen, Cabin in the Woods, Blair Witch Project, Hereditary, Descent, Sixth Sense, Shining, Ringu. Yeah, pretty much got it. Though, you know, the annoying thing about doing an episode like this is, right, I know for a fact that all three of us are going to go to bed tonight and there's going to be this moment of, fuck, why didn't I say that movie?
Hey, but that's fine.
That's
going
to happen.
Yeah, I literally, before this thing, I wrote down, I went through my IMDb list also. I went down all the movies that I'd seen. I'd written around 20 of them. Most of them got covered by all of us, you know.
Are we counting Get Out as horror? Because then it is one of the greatest all-time horror
no,
movies.
No, that's
thriller?
What I'm trying to say. Like
science fiction?
I mean, you can get into that entire scene, you know. Babadook, someone has mentioned.
Babadook is very, very good.
Listen, there was another movie I want to talk about as I saw as a kid. It's called The Boogeyman. Okay, no one ever talks about it. It was very, very shady animation for its time, but very, very, very scary. So if you get a chance to watch Boogeyman, please watch Boogeyman.
Was it a 1980? There's a 1980 Boogeyman and there's a 2005 Boogeyman.
No, it's a 2005 Boogeyman. Quite shady.
Sahil, you were not that young at that time, Sahil. You were literally 2 years away from being in the same class I was in college, Sahil. What are you talking about?
The first season of American Horror Stories was very good also.
I've never
yes.
seen that show.
It's
that
very
is a
good.
Show I
it's
want to
very,
watch.
Very, very, very,
very
good.
It's a... I don't
Afterlife
see,
mentioned that.
Do you have any quick records for... Okay, one last movie and then we'll quickly wrap it up with a few quick records for horror TV. One last movie that fucked around with my mind, Oculus. If you've ever seen Oculus.
Oculus was good.
Putting
Oculus
on list.
Really good.
Putting on list.
Oculus on was, list. Oh my god, what a messed up movie.
Putting
okay.
on list.
Quick records for horror shows before we wrap up.
We've Haunting got... of Hill House, for sure. American Horror Story, for sure.
Okay. Any other?
If you can, just for unsettling fun, if you can, there. So Showtime had this great show called Masters of Horror.
Mm-hmm.
Where for essentially standalone 1 hour stories, where they gave different legendary horror directors basically like a 1 hour short film, horror short film. So that has some great episodes. in Masters of Horror. Other than that, horror shows mein aur kya
hai? Horror shows mein maine kafi, I've not seen anything that's given me like a, oh, I'm getting scared or I'm freaked out or anything. I watch it and I'm like, ah, theek hai, cool. It's interesting, you know. Apart from Hill House. Hill House was the only
Midnight Mass is pretty fun.
I've not seen that yet, but I've been eyeing it. I must check it out.
It's fun. It's a little slow. It's a little slower than Hill House also, but it's fun.
Wow, chat has gone wild with that. Chat has gone wild. Dead Silence, Z Horror Show. Of course, we've spoken all of that. Aristotle, great name. The Ghost Stories Anthology. Yes, fantastic. That is the best. Jose still not recognizing that one.
I was going through, I typed horror on Netflix and I'm checking all the ones which I've seen and which I've not
Chucky
seen.
Chucky ka Indian copy, Papi Gudiya, is not scary, but Zapat Leela was scary.
Zapat Leela was scary. Zapat Leela was scary.
Mi Tatya Vinchu Aaye. Mi Tatya Vinchu Aaye. That was my favorite of all time.
Yeah, yeah, that was terrifying.
Pandorim, the Empty Man Possession. Have you guys seen any of those? No. I don't think so. Great. Guys, keep giving us your recommendations. I think Newt Scamander disappeared after I said, please make a list. I have not
seen. Can you keep the replay of the live chat on? That
I will.
Easiest.
No, the stream. The replay of the live chat is always on, but not only that, I've made a rough list. And what you guys do is, you guys also send me your list and I'll compile it and I'll create it and I'll add it to the chat. Exorcist
Rhythm
TV
says
series.
You've all missed the Exorcist TV series. Really, that's the thing.
We've not checked it out. We'll check it out.
Dabe, Turkish horror movie is supposed to be good. It's come up.
Hey, Makri. We have to talk about Makri.
Hey, Makri was great.
Great
Makri
movie.
Great.
It scared me.
Makri was good.
I always thought that I will be turned into a goat. I was actually scared as a kid because I thought that is how witchcraft happened. Listen, can I be honest? There is a place in Assam. Okay, it's known as the black magic capital of India. And I had stayed there at a village near there. And you know, we were saying we'll pass it, and they're like, don't. वहाँ पे आप जाओगे, आप कभी नहीं आओगे. मेरा दोस्त था, गया था, बकरी बन गया. So when I heard that, I thought it was truth. No, but that's the actual thing. It is there. It's an actual place.
Are you sure people didn't just scam him and he, like, literally like bakra banaya like that way? Like, I mean, I have to
Mayong.
Inquire.
Like, Mayong. It's called Mayong. Check it out after. It's an actual place in India, which is known as the black magic capital of
then someone
country.
Also saying it's called Jatinga.
No, it's called Mayong.
It's called Mayong. Yeah,
dude, scary stories I heard that day from the village people. They were scared shitless. They were like,
kuch nahi hai, yaar.
If you go, you will never come back. You will not be who you are. And I was like, okay, dude. Okay, then I guess I'm not going to.
Achha, acid milta hoga wahan pe bas. He was never the same again.
Am I bakra?
Because there's a couple of like... Rohit Nagar mentioned Suspiria. So in general, like the Dario Argento horror movies are great. Like all of them. Suspiria in particular is fantastic. Would 100% recommend.
Yeah, we've mentioned most of these.
But all those sort of giallo horror films are
Orphan, Midsommar. Yeah. Okay, guys. Keep putting in your chats. Please let us know. As soon as the stream is done, also please let us know at the bottom. I think we're going to wrap it up because I think it's 11:30. Rohan has to leave.
Yes.
I also have to go and cry in my room. And Jose also has to go sit like, be like, whatever.
A
whatever,
show about
whatever.
Crypto.
That is the real horror story where you put in your money and the government is like invalid. Before we go, a few quick announcements. Jose and Rohan, do you all have any announcements for the chat?
If you are in Mumbai, then tomorrow and day after, I am hosting some Comicstan open mic nights, which are happening at Above the Habitat. Tickets are still available. So if you look it up and you live in Mumbai, tomorrow 7:30, Saturday 7:30. Both those shows are happening. I am hosting a bunch of great comics, trying out a bunch of material, which will eventually all go on Comicstan. That's happening. Crossword stream will resume next week. So that's going to happen. And those are my, that is grand total.
Send me the link to the shows. I'll put it in the comment section. Jose, any announcements?
Please put your geyser off. Don't leave your gas on. It could be dangerous. I don't really have any announcements other than I'm doing
you
a scam stream
bastard.
Tomorrow.
Yeah.
Scam stream
I love
tomorrow and
I love this
ghost streams.
I love it. Tell us your ghost stories. Tell us your scam stories. Tell us your.
Yo, the scam stories was damn good. So many people have been scammed. It's insane.
Welcome to India.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. You think?
No, and not just over here, like abroad and all, people getting scammed in Germany, like Indians getting scammed in Germany, and what those scams are about and all. It's really.
My
wild,
grandma
man.
Called me last week, and she's like, this girl called me, and she said, I won 25 lakhs in the lottery. So how do I send her my details? And I'm like,
shit.
I need to talk to you.
Come here.
I need to talk to you.
Send me your details. Yeah. Send me your details and I'll give you better.
I have one announcement to make. Guys, I'm releasing new stand-up tomorrow on this channel. Finally.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's coming out at 7:30. So please, all those who are watching.
I'll stand up OP in chat, please. I'll stand up OP in chat.
All those who are watching, please subscribe karo. Yes, see, I put this cute little subscribe animation, but I played it only once in the stream because I was too focused on the stream to do it.
Do it right now.
I'm doing it now multiple times. It's on loop. But subscribe to the channel, guys, if you haven't.
Drop a Vatana.
Yeah. Join the Vatana army, Har army and Pishvi gang. Join all three gangs. Let's be part of this great great marketplace. This is our marketplace, you know.
Screw the Gucci gang. Yeah. This is where the party's at.
But please do subscribe to the channel. This is Binge O'Clock, guys. We are doing this. We have done this every week for the past 7 weeks.
Every
Rohan.
Week from, including from Bhopal.
Well done,
that's
guys.
The spirit, man. That's what from Bhopal, happening? Dude.
From you all stream Bhopal. From Bhopal also.
When I was in Bhopal, we streamed from there also.
That's the commitment. That is the commitment. Okay.
That is the commitment. When I was in Bhopal with No Way Home, we talked about Spider-Man, No Way Home.
Yeah.
It was great.
I just noticed that 13B is on Prime. I just saw.
Yes,
it.
Please watch
13B.
Very, very fun movie.
I'll watch 13B.
It's interesting. It's a fun movie. And these are all the references. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you everybody who saw it. As usual, I have mentioned it earlier, but once again, please subscribe to the channel. Tomorrow, new stand-up, scam stories, and go catch Rohan live in Mumbai. And lastly, thank you, Jose. Thank you for coming on board today. Yeah!
Thanks so much.
Jose, guys. Jose, JMDLR in the chat. I said that after a long time. But yeah, Jamatadi, let's rock to everybody. Thank you, Newt Scamander. I hope you've recorded everything. And like Thoko. Like Thoko, we are at 6:22. Thoda like Thoko. Khatam karte hai ye stream.
Hit it.
And to everybody watching, thank you so much for watching. We shall see you next week with another episode. As usual, let's cue the end music. 1, 2, 3, let's go.
Oh. Oh.
Destroying his end music. It sounds like we're torturing Sahil.
No, it sounds like we're torturing our condenser mic. That's what we're torturing.
Okay, I'm ending the stream. Bye!